Thank you for watching the Worst Guitar Channel. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Fact number 215. This is an image of guitarist John Mayer. He is known for many famous pop rock songs, including Your Body is a Wonderland and Daughters. Fact number 115. John Mayer has notoriously been known to play Fender Stratocasters throughout much of his career.
John Mayer has been a fan of Fender since he was a child. Like many kids growing up in America, his first electric guitar was an affordable Fender Squire. According to the GroundGuitar.com website, John said, "My first electric guitar was a Squire, so I've kind of grown up native to the shape and the sound and the feel of a Stratocaster. I kind of learned my way around the guitar on it." John later went on to purchase over 200 guitars, with the majority being Strats. But there was one particular guitar that helped define John as a powerful new breed of guitarist, inspired by the electric blues of Hendrix and Stevie Ray Vaughan. When John entered the Berklee School of Music, he brought with him the 1996 SRV Fender Stratocaster. This guitar had a solid alder body and Texas special pickups. John said, "This one I bought from the money I made working at a gas station, and I traded in a Takamine 12 string, and a Mesa Boogie distortion pedal. I think I paid around $900 as the difference. I bought it in 1996, and this thing has so many little stories on it. This has been in my bedroom when I was 19, practicing guitar playing, and Madison Square Garden, and Tokyo, and television shows. This is the representation of the places I've been." According to information over at Fender Reissue Shop website, John received two prototypes with serial numbers JM001 and JM002 in 2004. Both of these were custom built by Chris Fleming, and were used by John during the 2004 and 2005 tour dates. The GroundGuitar.com website went on to say that the guitar is heavily based on the Stevie Ray Vaughan tribute model, on which John relied for most of his career. The main difference is the orientation of the bridge, which was rotated 180 degrees back to its original position, and the pickups, which were replaced with a set of single coils designed with John's personal input. These pickups eventually became known as Big Dippers, and were available exclusively through one of John's signature guitars, meaning you couldn't buy them separately. According to the YouTube video, John Mayer, The Story of the Black One, Mayer says, "I had just gotten of a tour, and was just starting the Get Crazies from the second or third world tour. So, as soon as I had any time off, I called Fender and said, 'Can I come down and build a guitar? I wanted to build my main guitar. Since I was a kid, I would draw my own item details for the Fender Frontline catalog. I would draw freehand the Strat, the headstock, the tuning keys, and I would write Fender John Mayer signature Stratocaster. Then I would start writing all the details out, what kind of pickups would it have, what kind of this and that." According to the Music Radar, John said, "The Black One just struck. All of a sudden this guitar started doing it. And as the guitar started to age, it got different. Within months it started to sound different. So it was a labor of love, and it's all of the Continuum record. It's in a couple places on Battle Studies, but it really is the Continuum guitar, you know. It's just fucking great every time. It's the best feeling guitar I've ever played."
Here are some more Artist Series guitars that Fender made for John Mayer. The John Mayer Continuum guitar, named after his album in 2006. The John Mayer Cypress Mica guitar. Only 300 of these guitars were released in the USA. Once there was a little boy and everything turned out all right. Or was it? Fact number 325. Now it's time to say goodbye to Fender.
John Mayer stated in an interview with MusicRadar.com, "I had an idea for a guitar, and this goes back about 10 years, a guitar that is sort of the future of the classic, street, design. It was not going to work with Fender. They weren't going to be able, one way or another, to bring the vision that I had to life. So, not pissed off, I wanted to go somewhere where they could bring that vision to life. And it made a lot of sense to go to Paul because that's the guy who started the company. To be able to call the guy who started the company on the phone, and talk directly about ideas and how to build them, that's good for you. It's good to have artists be able to call the guy who runs the company. I couldn't do that really at Fender because it's musical chairs, you don't know who to call. I get to call the guy whose name is on the guitar, and we get to build stuff together. That's too cool."
After 2 years of research and development, PRS introduces guitar that looks a bit like a Fender Stratocaster.
The internet is up in arms about the new John Mayer guitar, the PRS Silver Sky. It was the result of 2 years of redesign and retooling. It's a totally new and innovative guitar. But even with all the new refinements, it still looks like a Strat. From the three single coil pickups, to the bolt-on neck, to the bridge, it just looks like a Strat. This has left many Fender and PRS fans confused and a little upset at why the design has no consistency with every other PRS guitar that has been made. In an interview with the YouTube channel, Anderton's Music Co., Paul Reed Smith describes how interesting this new design is, but many of the comments have said just the opposite.
Where did you get the inspiration for such an original and unusual design? Leo Fender did a really amazing job designing it for this company. I just can't get over how stupid the headstock looks on a Strat-style body. The Donald Trump of guitar making speaks. Complete egomaniac. They just had to slightly change the dimensions of all the parts, so it's not a Fender. So two of those things that are dead wrong, are present in his other guitars?
Despite all of the criticism, most people agree that the Silver Sky guitar sounds amazing, and it was designed for John Mayer specifically. In the Music Radar interview he states, "This has a lot to do with taking what my favorite 64 Strat is, taking the overall sensibility and tone of that guitar, and giving it to people so that it becomes not something that's impossible to get for most people. I just love the idea of bringing it down to a place of accessibility for people, and I think to a certain extent, that's really happened." Paul is a scientist as much as he is an artist. One aspect of the guitar's press release that particularly raised eyebrows is the 2 years it took to build the Silver Sky, something John Mayer also set out to clarify. Why did it take 2 years? It's striking a lot of people as sort of a farce that it took 2 years. Well, it's a game of millimeters when you deal with making a guitar that is based off of the Strat. Again, this guitar is based off of the Strat. I think if people understood that I'm admitting that, yes, I have played a Strat for such a long time in my career that it didn't make sense to me personally to look down and see a different shape, and I don't think other people would want to see a different shape.
Thank you for watching the Worst Guitar Channel. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Mm-hmm.